guide you with an eye of love requite.
The sucker, I think you had from me. From Claudio Amethyst. But what's your will?
Your answer, sir, is enigmatical. But for my will is your good will may stand with ours, this day to be conjoined in the state of honorable marriage, in the which good friar I shall desire your help.
My heart is in your liking.
And my help? You come to Prince Claudio.
Good morrow to this fair assembly.
Good morrow, Prince. Good morrow. Here we attend you. Are you determined today to manage my brother's son?
I'll hold my mind for she and Ethio.
Call it forth, brother. Here's the friar ready.
Good morrow, Benedict. Why, what's the matter that you have such a February face? So full of frost, of storm, of cloudiness.
I think he thinks the month is out. Well, here come other remnants. Which is the lady I must seize upon?
This saying is she, and I give you her.
Why then, she's mine. Sweet. Your face.
No, that you shall not. Then take your hand before this friar. Swear to marry.
Give me your hand. Before this holy friar, I am your husband, if you like of me.
And when I live, I was your other wife. And when you love, you were my other husband.
Another hero!
Nothing certainer. One hero died at five, but I do live, and surely as I live, I am made.
The former hero that is dead.
She died, my lord, but while her standard.
All this amazement can I qualify, when after not the holy rites are ended. I'll tell you largely of fair hero's death. Meantime, let wonder seem familiar. And to the chapel let us presently.
Soft and prayer friar, which is Beatrice?
I answer that name. What is your will?
Do not you love me?
Why, no. No more than reason.
Why, then your uncle and the Prince of Claudio have been deceived, for they swore you did.
Do not you love me?
Trust no, no more than reason.
Why, then my cousin, Margaret and Ursula, have been much deceived, for they did swear you did.
They swore you were all sick for me.
They swore you were both my dead for me.
Tis no such matter. Then you do not love me.
No, truly, but in friendly recompense.
Come, cousin. I'm sure you love the gentleman, and I'll be sworn upon that he loves her. For here's the paper written in his hand. A hopeful sonnet of his own pure brain, fashioned to Beatrice.
And here's another, written in my cousin's hand, stolen from her pocket, containing her affection as a Benedict!
A miracle! Here's her own hands against our hearts. Come, I will have thee. But by this light, I take thee for pity.
Ah!
I do not deny you, but by this good day, I feel upon great persuasion. Partly to save your life, for I was told you were in a consumption.
Oh, peace! I will stop her mouth.
How dost thou, Benedict the married man?
I'll tell thee what, prince. Oh, a college of woodcarkers cannot flood me out of my humor. Dost thou think I care for a satire or an epigram? In brief, since I didn't propose to marry, I will think nothing to any purpose that the world can say against it, and therefore never flood me for what I have said against it, for man is a giddy thing. This is my conclusion. For thy part, Claudio, I did think to have beaten thee, but in that thou art like to be my kinsman, live unbruised, and love my cousin.
I did well hope thou wouldst have denied, Beatrice, that I might have cudgeled thee out of thy single life, to make thee a double dealer, which, but a question thou would be, if my cousin does not look exceedingly narrowly to thee.
Come, we are friends. Let's have a dance ever, Mary. We lighten our hearts and the wives. thee a wife.
Get thee a wife!
My lord, your brother John is to be in flight and brought the armored men back to the sea.
I think not of him till tomorrow. I'll devise thee brave punishments.